And do you trust God with the above and beyond? That's really what this comes down to. If you can say, I'm an unworthy servant, I just did what's expected of me, if I just made coffee in the kingdom of God, you're saying you trust God with the above and beyond. Do you trust Him with that? Will you just be a coffee maker in the kingdom of God? Think about this. You think that the Old Testament is kind of hard because all those commandments and rules and regulations you have to follow. You know, we talked about that a few months ago. We were, what, 613 was that the number? And this kind of rocked my world when I looked it up today. There are 1,050 commandments in the New Testament. Now, we thought the Old Testament was bad, but and when I say that, let me give you some examples, but I want to ask you a question. What would your, as we're talking about faithfulness and trying to wrap this up, what does it look like if I live out faithfulness? What would your life look like if I did some of the commands in the New Testament? Now, take that into context of what I'm saying. If commands are not in that you've got to print out this list and check all these off every day. What it means is if you're faithful, you will soon see that your life begins to mirror these things. Here's some ideas. If you want to be faithful, here's just a snippet of what the New Testament tells us to do. Repent. Follow me. Jesus said, follow me. Rejoice. See, it's not all burdens. It's not burdens and commands we're talking about, but he told us to do. Rejoice. Let your light shine before men. Are you faithful in that? Junior, seniors, Chad just challenged you with that. Is your light shining before these young guys in here? Love your enemies. That kind of gets back to forgiveness. Are we faithful in doing those things? Ask and it shall be given. That's a command in the New Testament. Do we ask and expect God to give? Do we ask judge not. Pray. That's a command in the New Testament. Pray. Do we do that? Love God. Love your neighbor. Love one another. Forgive. And be faithful in these things. So you also will have done all that you have commanded. Last week, we ended with asking, will you forgive? Do you can you forgive? Well, this week it's, will you be faithful? Will you be faithful? Remember what faithfulness is. It's been something important. It means commitment. What's important in your life? Chad challenged you with, how's your walk? How's your relationship with Christ? Is it important in your life? Then if it is, you combine that with commitment. Folks, a walk with Jesus doesn't just happen. It's got to be important. And you've got to be committed to it. So are you faithful? because you are faithful, God is faithful, you're faithful to others, you can forgive. So we're going to challenge you with that every week. Pray with me. Father, loving God, we just want to thank you for this time together. Lord, what just a wonderful time of worship. God, a chance just to spend time with your friends. Lord, to just enjoy this fellowship together. Lord, I thank you for the hard teaching that's in your word. Lord, but sometimes we have to stop and really examine our lives. Lord, we have to ask hard questions. We have to deal with tough issues.